Thanks for joining another RIVAGE PM10 video log. Let me show you some cool tips for operating the control surface. They work on the original large surface and the new smaller one. Starting at the top, we have the view key. This simply toggles between the channel overview and the selected channel view. For the third screen, use the escape key on the keyboard to do the same function. Now, see this row of channel encoders above the faders? You can assign 5 parameters to them and scroll through the assignments with these keys by the side. The adjacent function key can work in tandem with the encoder. For example, when the high pass filter is assigned to the encoder, the function key switches it on and off. Now let's go to the setup menu and look at the panel settings here. You can create a different brightness for the screen, LEDs, and the lamps. Perhaps one for daytime and one for night. If you're working at an open-air festival, you can easily switch between the modes with the user-defined keys. One more key on the surface to talk about is the home key. There's one for each bank. It will instantly recall your favorite fader layer and screen view. For example, select the DCA faders here, and if I want the EQ for the main vocal on the screen, then let's get that and press and hold home key. Then, wherever you are in the layers and the menus, press home and you always get back. Talking of the EQ, have you noticed bank A and B here? It allows a quick setting change. For example, an electric guitar changes from clean to crunch, or a snare drum changes from brushes to sticks. Each bank can even be a different EQ type, and you have the same bank choices in the dynamics as well. Now let's move to the delay tab. You can set the scale to meters or feet, but maybe you think that 2 meter steps here are not so convenient. Well, all you have to do is push the encoder down for fine tuning. This allows for both quick and fine adjustments. The same happens with many other parameters too, and you find exactly that way of working with the CL and the QL series consoles. But alternatively, you can tap the delay parameter to open up the delay time pop-up. Then just type a numerical value. The last tip of the day is found in the patch menu. Maybe you need to quickly set up for a live recording. So get the cursor moved to the start of the grid, press the diagonal button, twist the touch and turn knob to reach the end of the required range, and then press the green tick to confirm. Well, I hope you've enjoyed learning some new tips. I'll see you again next time.